If you want to skip the intro and get right into the video, skip to this timestamp or check out the timestamps in the description. Welcome, members of the ever-growing VR horde. My name is Rex, this is Eyes on VR, and I've been privileged enough to be sent a brand new version of the ForceTube module by the amazing people at ProTube VR. It's finally cheaper. Our prayers have been answered. I'm going to compare the old and the new ForceTubes, but I'm also going to show you what the ForceTube can do in general and what it's all about. Your immersion is about to be kicked up a whole nother gear, so let's get into it. As our YouTube overlords demand, I must say before we get into the video that I am not sponsored by ProTube VR. I am not being paid by them to compare or review the latest ForceTubes. Many thanks, of course, to ProTube VR for the chance to do this with the ForceTube and for the amazing interactions I have with them every time we speak. If you're interested in the ForceTube or any of their other awesome VR products, please use the link down in the description below. So I'm going to start by going over who ProTube VR are and what the ForceTube is, and then I'll go into the difference between the two. But as a sneak peek of what the difference is...
this thing is amazing!
Oh my goodness.
The original was like the tester. It works great, but improvements could have been made. The new one is its streamlined VR ForceTube older brother. Sleeker, lighter, cheaper, but with the same power and amazing battery life as the original. But first, who are ProTube VR? They're a small business, and that's one of the things I really like about ProTube VR, because I love a small independent business. There's only about 12 to 15 people that work there, so when your order is made and packed, it's not just all machines. Real people are checking your item, real people are packing it, giving it extra checks, and taking care of it through the whole process. And this small company is really massive in the VR community, providing gunstocks and accessories for all VR headsets for both casual players and professional players, as their equipment is used in the VR Master League by some of the best VR players in the world. They're known and respected in this industry, and that is really impressive for a smaller company. But the last thing is the products are quality. Things cost a bit more, but that's why. And at the end of the day, just like any independent retailer, you get what you pay for. If you were to ever have a problem, these guys are there. They will know your order and they will know you and they will help you. And if you want to check out details of the company and their products, just use the link in the description of this video. So what's a ForceTube? A ForceTube is an accessory for the ProTube MagTube gunstock that ProTube VR sell. I've done a full look and review of that gunstock and you can check it out here. In short, the MagTube is amazing and works with any VR shooter that exists, even if it doesn't have gunstock settings. Its versatility is its biggest strength, that is for sure, not to mention it's made of carbon fiber. The ForceTube is a haptic feedback module which will replace the butt of your ProTube MagTube gunstock. Wow, that's a mouthful. What this means is the butt of your ProTube MagTube will kick back at you while you're firing a rifle, just like in real life. How it works is there's a bit in the back here that kicks back against your shoulder. And you know what? First up, let's get this out of the way. How does it feel?
Okay, my life is complete. My life is complete. That was great.
I think that kind of speaks for itself. Now to note, this is the original ForceTube. The one with all this branding is the original, not the new one. I'll show you the newer one in the comparison, obviously. I just want people who have not seen a ForceTube before or the new one to get a full understanding of how much difference there is between the two. I'd go over exactly how to use the ForceTube, but ProTube provides you with all those instructions when you get one. So to get the ForceTube onto your ProTube MagTube, simply unscrew the old butt of your ProTube MagTube using the Allen key that they provide you. Set that aside, line up the MagTube, and just screw it in here. Easy, simple, quick. I recommend doing it on a floor or a table though, or you're gonna have bits going all over the place. Once it's attached, just turn it on. You'll also see lights inside the module to confirm that it is waiting for a connection. Now the ProTube ForceTube can be used on both Oculus Quest, Oculus Quest 2, and PC VR. It does this by using a Bluetooth connection. Now PC owners that don't have built-in Bluetooth with your computer or laptop, never fear, as ProTube has you covered and they will send you a free Bluetooth dongle with your ForceTube, which is a real baller move. ProTube VR will also supply you with the instructions on getting the ProTube ForceTube accompanying app. So once you're connected, open that up and you can customize anything you like about the ForceTube. The kickback strength for each kind of weapon, even though it does have preset. The rumble, which is really fun when firing a laser weapon. And more. After that, just open one of the games that supports the ForceTube. They have a list on the ProTube website. But just to name a few, Hot Dogs, Horseshoes and Hand Grenades, or H3 VR. Onward, Contractors, Pavlov, the newly released Sniper Elite VR, AimXR, and more. After that, check the in-game settings of whatever game that you decide to use it with. There's normally a switch in the settings to turn on its ability to use the ForceTube. Once you're done with that, experience your weapon kickback while you play in VR and get yourself even deeper into the action.
It's like this is what's missing for your brain.
So now you know what the ForceTube is and how it works, what's the difference between the two models and why should you care? So first off, let's take a look. So the original is on the left here and the new ForceTube module is on the right, and instantly you can see the size difference. And that size difference decreases the weight by almost 200 grams. And believe me, it needs it, as the original is very bulky. It's not a bad thing per se. I enjoyed the large size of the original module as I have quite big shoulders. So I like a big gun stock, but this is still a nice size for me and it sits quite comfortably in my shoulder. The less weight helps when you switch to a pistol. The weight of the old one felt very heavy on your neck when not holding it, but the new one is a lot more comfortable. Now, just to be clear, the new module will have ProTube branding and stuff like that on it, as you can see on their website. Mine's just a version without the branding because I've had it a bit before release. Now, how did they achieve this? This will lead into price, so stay tuned. They've put better and more up-to-date hardware inside of the ForceTube, and that's enabled them to have smaller parts. And fortunately, ProTube have listened to feedback from customers and VR gamers that have said things like, oh, the old module is too bulky, and most importantly, it's way too expensive.
Oh yeah. Yeah, it feels good. It feels good. Oh, I'm so relieved. I really thought, because of how much different this is to the older one, and it's cheaper, I thought it would be worse, but it's not. Big relief.
The original model would set you back almost 350 euros after tax. That's over $400. But with the new module, they've cut the dead weight, they've improved it, and they've cut the price down to under $300 before tax. It's still not cheap, and I hear you. I'm a cheap guy, and this is still a lot. But if I offered you two tech items of the same thing, but one had a better, more up-to-date hardware, was newer, more comfortable, lighter, but did all the same things, but with a good 50, 60 bucks knocked off the price after tax, that doesn't sound like a bad deal, does it? Or maybe it does to you, I don't know. I'll tell you this. Again, you get what you pay for. If you want the good stuff, this is a damn fine place to get it. With a small company making big waves in the VR world, who are known and respected by customers, VR competitors, and the industry in general. I won't sit here and tell you that the ForceTube is a necessity for you to get, but if you can get it or someone would get it for you, oh hell yes, get one of these. Your immersion goes through the roof. When I'm crouched down behind a car or rock in a game in a firefight, I'm even more in it than before. What's really fun is you get to a point where your brain just accepts the ForceTube so much that you kind of forget about it. Which I know sounds crazy, but it's because you're so in the game through VR anyway that your brain just logically feels that kickback within it. You'll forget that the ForceTube is even there, but then if you play a game without it, you'll feel it in your brain. Your brain will know that something isn't right. Something's off, something's missing. The ForceTube hits you consciously first, and then subconsciously. It hits you on all levels, and honestly, it's amazing. What's great about the ForceTube as well is you don't have to have it turned on every time you use it, but you can leave it attached to your ProTube MagTube, and it makes quite a better stock, in my opinion, than the standard butt stock that you get with the ProTube MagTube. The ForceTube is just heavier, you know, it's metal, it's just got a more solid, beefy feeling in your shoulder. The original stock is absolutely fine, there is nothing wrong with it. I used it for a long time before I started using the ForceTube as well. I just like that little extra weight and that extra oomph that the ForceTube gives out. Like I said, this thing isn't a necessity, but if you can get it or someone to get it for you, definitely get it, because it just ups your immersion a whole nother level, and it's really fun. I can't really explain it. It's tough to show you exactly how fun and amazing this thing is in person when it's just a video, when it's something you need to feel to experience, but believe me, it's really awesome. Like I said before, if you want to check out ProTube VR or the ForceTube, just go into the link in the description down below and have a look through there. I've been talking about the ForceTube so much, it's given me the itch to go and use it again, so I'm going to go fire off a big LMG with some Force haptic kickback in my shoulder. So there's nothing left to say, but my name is Rex, this is Eyes on VR, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time.